Welcome to DuPage Children's Museum's 2021 Play Soirée, a virtual celebration of creativity, resilience, and perseverance. I'm Larry Mowry, ABC7 meteorologist, and I'm in my weather center this evening for this virtual event. You know, as a scientist and a father of two amazing girls, I'm so pleased to be returning as your MC to support DCM. Collaborating with the team to prepare for this event has given me unique access to the determined problem solvers who, with creativity and focus, have helped this great organization through a very challenging time. We should all be very proud and inspired to support this incredible museum in our community. Tonight's program will feature DCM leaders, partners, advocates, and beneficiaries who have played a critical role in the extraordinary success of the museum during the last 15 months. The pandemic has created so many unique challenges, but many of you have risen to meet those challenges. To elaborate on the organization's success story, I'm so pleased to introduce DCM Board Chair Mark Trimbacki.
Thank you, Larry. It's great to be here tonight. Nimbleness, innovation, and resilience. Three words that define the DuPage Children's Museum. Throughout its nearly 35-year history, more than once, DCM has responded to events that threatened its very existence. 2020 put us to the test yet again, and I'm delighted and proud to say we not only survived, but we thrived. And the best part is, these are the attributes we work to stimulate and develop in our young learners. It's good to practice what you teach. Nimbleness. What does an organization do when its earned revenues from memberships, admissions, and programs drop to zero overnight? When hands-on learning, a hallmark of DCM, moves from a positive attribute to a heavy burden? The DCM team attacked the challenge from all angles to develop new revenue sources, preserve cash, access government support programs, and ultimately develop new programs in record time. Innovation. Delivering our mission in a virtual environment is no easy task. These results speak for themselves. 520 arts and STEM with DCM labs delivered to local school districts in Naperville, Aurora, West Chicago, and more as well at community institutions like DuPage PADS, Ann and Robert H. Lurie Children's Hospital, and the YMCA. 17,500 instructional hours for 10,400 children across our region. The Naperville 203 STEM partnership alone served 7,000 kids with 2 hours each. We also hired 24 facilitators who brought the world to our audience. Four from LA, one in Mexico City, one from Puerto Rico, and a handful from the New Jersey, New York City area. And of course, a few from Chicago and some from Naperville. Nearly 440,000 children and their caregivers engaged via our social media platforms in story time, hands-on activities, and sing-alongs through Play to Learn at Home. Impressive outcomes under any circumstances. Resilience. Experimenting, making mistakes, adjusting, trying again. This cycle of play and learning builds resilient problem solvers. At DCM, we create environments where children can explore the possibilities and build critical thinking skills to last a lifetime. DCM leveraged this same cycle of learning to navigate the last 15 months of uncertainty and volatility amid a constantly changing social, medical, financial, and educational environment. This determination allowed DCM to provide children fun and meaningful challenges to feel satisfaction and pride in their outcomes, even when they weren't with us physically. The excitement, gratitude, and joy of our young learners has fueled this team to keep them focused on new solutions for children and their adult learning partners. I want to thank the DCM team for their commitment, trust, and grit. We would not be here tonight without this amazing team of creative and caring individuals. I also want to express my personal gratitude and that of the board of directors to Andrea Wiles, who was only 3 months in her new role as CEO when the pandemic broke out. But fortunately for us, not only is she a quick study, but she fell in love with all things DCM. Her unwavering leadership has been nothing short of awe-inspiring. Thank you, Andrea. It's been a true pleasure and privilege to work with you. DCM is a remarkable treasure in Naperville and across Chicagoland, as well as a recognized leader across the country. This year's hard-fought success story will undoubtedly serve as an enduring benchmark for nonprofit organizations, particularly those serving our youngest learners. I hope our story of nimbleness, innovation, and resilience inspires you to support this incredible organization. To share more about the impactful STEM partnerships between DCM and Naperville School District 203, I'm pleased to introduce Scott Elementary School Principal Hugh Boger.
One of the biggest challenges that our students and teachers faced was experiencing the joy of learning. You know, teachers don't join the profession to teach, they join the profession to watch kids learn. And sometimes it felt like in the online environment that teachers weren't watching the kids learn, weren't feeling it, weren't seeing it, weren't hearing it. DuPage Children's Museum bridged the gap between what we felt like we could do in online learning and what we felt like we knew about good teaching and learning with kids. And that was to get them excited, to get them exploring. Science, technology, engineering, and math, STEM, at DuPage Children's Museum was a wonderful opportunity for them to provide instruction and materials to build and to create. Several parents reached out to me and said, "I haven't seen my child that excited about the school day in a long time. My child feels good about learning and feels like it's okay to be at home because there's a way to learn from there as well."
So on day one, I would start with my dry seeds.
My favorite DCM,
making animals.
I hope you're excited to create your very own creature today.
DuPage Children's Museum has been a critical partner for us, especially this year. We know they have a vested interest in our community. We know that they care about our students. We know that they know 203. We know that they know our mission of being passionate about lifelong learning. So it's somebody that we feel very confident in spending our money and partnering with to make sure that our kids are learning and growing, and it's a together we can concept where everybody's in it together.
We love DuPage,
Children's Museum.
It was fantastic to hear from Principal Boger about how STEM with DCM transformed teaching and learning for students this year. My boys also enjoyed virtual STEM with DCM programming. That made a creative, hands-on, problem-solving fun for them. For another year, DCM's Play Soirée is a virtual benefit ball, and the funds raised at this evening's event are vital to our continued march toward our vision to create equitable access to exceptional early learning experiences. As viewers watch tonight, please consider giving. I personally give to the museum because our boys do have access to DCM. It's in our community and through their school. They loved going to DCM pre-pandemic, but our two-year-old daughter has never been able to visit because of the pandemic shutdown. My wife Bonnie and I are so excited to be able to have her discover, explore, and play in the exhibits.
Thank you, Cam. From exhibit experiences to school programs to social media programming, all of our content creation and delivery this last year was made possible through the support of our funding partners. The Play Soirée is off to a great start because of our corporate sponsors, and I would like to thank our presenting sponsor, Molex, lead sponsor, Wintrust, advocate sponsors, PNC, and McCormick Foundation. Also, special thanks to the Gala Committee for their support in making Play Soirée a joyful celebration of creativity, resilience, and perseverance. To explain a little bit more about why we were able to celebrate vision and values tonight, it is my pleasure to introduce DuPage Children's Museum CEO, Andrea Wiles. Andrea?
Good evening, and thank you again for being with us tonight. Wow, what a year. You know, there was a moment early in the pandemic when our board chair, Mark Trembecki, and I were discussing the very difficult decisions that we had before us and the work of the museum with the building closed. I remember saying that a year will go by like a moment, and soon we'll be looking back at the consequences of our decisions. We needed to plan for the future now. We needed to create the backbone of what we wanted to be after the pandemic. And here we are, at that very moment we knew would come. We are here because of you, because of a dedicated board devoted through floods and pandemics, because of a resilient and creative staff, and because of the collaboration and dedication of families, donors, partners, and stakeholders throughout the communities we serve. During the pandemic, we elected not to hibernate. We leaned into early learning. We leaned into science, technology, engineering, arts, and math. And we leaned into equity. We convened over 50 community members, including parents, caregivers, pediatricians, business leaders, educators, entrepreneurs, scientists, leaders of social service agencies, and philanthropists. Our goal was to learn about the challenges, new and old, facing our communities, to understand the barriers, real and perceived, standing between children, and the resources to ensure they thrive, and to learn about solutions. Solutions developed in partnership to combat isolation and to build community. We developed content and structures to deliver it. Our focus was to invest in our future as an essential partner in the education and engagement of our children in play, arts, and sciences. Our efforts were not about creating a Band-Aid for a short-term problem. Our work is about creating sustainable, equitable access to remarkable impact. We created a playful, accessible presence on social media. We now reach living rooms everywhere with bilingual story time, art projects, sing-alongs, words of inspiration, and social-emotional support. More than once, the creativity and talent and commitment of the DCM team literally brought tears of pride and joy to my eyes. We provided ongoing direct support to families through our Partners in Play program. Our persistence helped find new ways to connect and empower families. We transitioned many of these strategies to Tiny Text Tips, a program that provides activities, connections, and joy to families wherever they are and whenever they can engage. We learned that Zoom and other platforms are not about DCM providing virtual programming. They are tools to deliver hands-on, engaging, arts and STEM fun. The only virtual element is the facilitation. The rest is very, very real and very impactful. We have delivered STEM with DCM labs to children in hospital rooms, homeless shelters, after-school programs, and in schools serving communities across our region. And wow, did I learn about humility and my own privilege. I will forever have a memory of one of our team members bouncing her teething one-year-old over her head as she calmly walked the leadership team through the project plan for a major event. My awe at the resilience and talent of DCM team members runs deep. Also deep is DCM's dedication to support all parents and caregivers searching for success in work, life, and pandemic parenting. Whether through our parent play shops or through our webinar series, engaging speakers and working parents across the country, we made it our mission to break through the walls of isolation, to support those juggling the nearly impossible, while the ground on which they stood shifted constantly. Now, we are able to celebrate the return of our most cherished tool to advancing play, early learning, and STEAM. The big red door is open again. Soon we will welcome Rosie Revere, engineer, Ada Twist, scientist, Iggy Peck, architect, Sophia Valdez, future prez, and the other children of Ms. Lila Greer's classroom when we premiere the Questioneers Read, Question, Think, Play exhibit. We have felt the presence of these characters, their courage and persistence, as we navigated the pandemic and designed this exhibit. We are grateful for these simple, critical lessons shared with the world by author Andrea Beatty. Our vision is that all children have access to exceptional early learning and STEAM experiences. We cannot reach this vision alone. We are committed to work in partnership with parents, caregivers, and all who serve them to build pathways, the bridges, the tunnels, and the momentum to ensure the opportunity for each child to reach their full, unique learning potential. The path to our future, the path to equity, begins in early childhood and traverses through exceptional experiences in play, discovery, science, math, and engineering. DuPage Children's Museum is not a nice to have. It is a must have. We are the nimble partner in our communities who can fill gaps and remove barriers. As a partner, not alone, together. To highlight the power of partnership and working together, I am pleased to introduce President and CEO of DuPage Pads, April Redzik.
DuPage Children's Museum has been a great partner to us and to the community at large because they're helping bring programming to children that otherwise wouldn't have that opportunity. Our goal is to end homelessness for people in DuPage County. And what we started to see at the onset of COVID, especially in the fall, was that we had great numbers of families come to us. We had babies in strollers. We had children in car seats. A third of those we were serving became children. And so the Children's Museum came in and did programming. They worked with the kids in our programs to not only have something fun to do on the weekend, not only something to help their parents have tools to help their kids grow and learn, but also to help them think bigger about their futures, to think about what they want to be when they grow up. A lot of these kids, their families have been struggling with poverty, with not knowing where they're going to sleep at night. It is hard to think about what comes next when you don't know what your life is going to be day to day, when you don't know you have a safe space to stay in. And the Children's Museum came in and worked with the kids in our programs so they could dream bigger, so they could learn more. And by the end, we had a little guy who said he wanted to become a scientist. And that to me is just really incredible. And the fact that they've been able to help us bring resources in the area where they have expertise, where they have people who know what kids need to learn and grow and bring that into children who quite frankly need it the most in our community is really incredible. So it's allowed our kids to dream bigger, to have a lot of joy, and to have more opportunities to learn and grow.
Thank you, April. Your stories of impact underscore the importance of encouraging all children to see themselves as scientists. I am thrilled to introduce an extraordinary individual who shares our vision and these values, Dr. Jatia Hart. Jatia holds a PhD in nuclear engineering and currently leads a portfolio of research and analysis for Argonne National Laboratory. Dr. Hart is passionate about encouraging and facilitating inclusion of underrepresented and underserved communities in STEM. She uses her professional platform to illuminate the importance of children seeing people who look like them in STEM roles to inspire their aspirations to become our next generation of scientists, engineers, and innovators.
Hello, my name is Ada Twist. Okay, my name isn't Ada, but
I am an extremely brilliant Black woman scientist with boundless imagination and curiosity. I am Dr. Jatia Hart, a nuclear engineer and national security researcher. It is my job to ask the tough questions and figure out the why for U.S. decision makers like presidents and senators. And my specialty is understanding and explaining science, technology, engineering, and math. My work answers questions about quantum and explains the bounds of biology. My path to being a professional know-it-all, like Ada's journey, began with many questions in school. But I can tell you that a seven-year-old who wants to debate methodology with a teacher does not go over so well. My parents, like Ada's, channeled my curiosity into productive activities like learning. I devoured every math and science class that was within my reach. I took biology in the summer so I could look at frog guts. I took algebra in night school class so I could tell my mom how long a car trip should take. I'd taken so many science and math classes that soon I needed to seek out even higher education. So I graduated from high school early, left home, and started attending Florida State University full-time when I was 15. And when I stepped foot on that campus after all those math and science classes that I took to quench my burning desire to know everything, I knew exactly what major was for me. You guessed it, business management. At the time, I thought scientists were white men with weird hair, tech meant Bill Gates, engineers were construction workers, and the only professional I knew who used math was my mom, an accountant. I really didn't see myself as a person who could succeed in STEM. I changed my major to engineering because my parents understood teenage motivation and promised me a car. Luckily, in my life, I have people who guide me and encourage me to think big and dream bigger. And throughout college, I continued to ask, like Ada, lots of questions. When I had the opportunity to go aboard a submarine, I asked, what are these metal tubes running vertically through the boat? And what exactly is powering this boat? The tubes were missile silos that could launch nuclear weapons, and the boat was powered by nuclear energy. Those two questions sparked my interest and plotted my trajectory towards a career as a nuclear engineer researching uses of STEM to encourage peaceful applications. Today, I am a successful Black woman engineer and leader, but I had to overcome many challenges in my education and career, including fielding questions about whether I was good enough to make it in STEM and not being included because I was different in a profession made for men. A 2020 American Association of University Women study reinforces my experience, showing that women in STEM are viewed as less competent than their male counterparts, and those viewed as competent are viewed as less likable. Questions about competency and likability lead to women not selecting STEM careers and lack of progress and attrition from women in the fields of STEM. To mitigate this, AAUW calls for nurturing the STEM talent of women and challenging gender bias in the field. In the 31 pages of Ada Twist, Scientist, Andrea Beatty accomplishes both aspects beautifully in a delightful and eye-opening story of a gifted young woman. Miss Twist is passionate about science, and the only questions other characters have is how will they keep up? To the future scientists and engineers like Ada and my younger self, and all the other curious girls with curious thoughts who want to know what the world is about, I tell you, don't worry. We'll figure it out. Thank you.
What a great message. Thank you so much, Dr. Jatia Hart, for sharing your powerful journey about curiosity and where it can take a person who is nurtured. You are exactly the type of role model I want for my daughters, a strong, vibrant, brilliant woman determined to make discoveries, provide solutions, and offer good counsel to our leaders. How wonderful that you partnered with the AAUW, the American Association of University Women, to foster female talent in STEM careers. As DCM CEO Andrea Wiles told us, DCM actively generates solutions as an essential partner in the community, creating sustainable impact to remarkable impact. Science often provides us with answers, but we also need creativity, courage, and persistence to advance those solutions in service of humanity. That is what makes DuPage Children's Museum so important for children, parents, and caregivers, and those who work in service of our children, developing the next generation of innovators and problem solvers. DCM knows that early childhood experiences make all the difference in the life of a child. You heard the DuPage PAD CEO say that DCM inspired their children in crisis to think, question, and play their way to dreaming bigger. Big thinkers come to life in the Questioneers book series, and their bravery, resilience, and creativity inspired the development of an exciting new exhibit exclusive to DCM. To share more about the importance of the joy of learning through diverse literary characters that inspire children, I'm so pleased to introduce another remarkable leader in our region. Andrea Sines is Chief Operating Officer for the Chicago Community Trust, where she partners with colleagues across the organization to deliver on its mission and goals. Sines joined the Trust from the Chicago Public Library, where she served as first Deputy Commissioner and Chief Strategy Officer. She previously served as Chief of Staff to Chicago Public Schools CEO, leading and planning and implementing of district-wide initiatives. Sines' previous roles include Policy Advisor to the Assistant Secretary for Career, Technical, and Adult Education at the U.S. Department of Education, and Executive Director of the Hispanic Alliance for Career Enhancement, a national nonprofit working with employers, universities, and schools to increase Latinos' entry and success in professional careers. Career exploration rooted in innate curiosity and creativity of children come alive in the Questioneers books. I think you will enjoy Andrea's perspective on the importance of the author and the world of characters she has created to inspire children to explore, discover, create, and persevere. Now, to share more about the significance of DCM's 2021 Great Friend to Kid Award, Andrea Sines.
This past year has required resiliency, perseverance, and creativity from all of us and our institutions. Today we gather, still virtually, to celebrate the continued creativity and perseverance of the DuPage Children's Museum, and to recognize a trailblazer in championing the importance of nurturing these characteristics in all of our young people, Andrea Beatty. When life as we knew it came to a halt last year, the DuPage Children's Museum staff adapted and accelerated programming to continue to serve its community. The museum's science, technology, engineering, arts, and math program, known as its STEAM programming, provided hands-on education to children in hospitals, homeless shelters, at community-based organizations, and most recently, to over 7,000 elementary school children across Naperville School District. So it's fitting that this year's Great Friends to Kids Award recognizes Andrea Beatty, author of the Questioneers book series that honors all our children's bravery, resilience, and creativity through characters like Iggy Peck, architect, Rosie Revere, engineer, Sophia Valdez, future prez, and Ada Twist, scientist. Ms. Beatty's inclusive and compelling vision for young people to explore historically exclusive careers beautifully challenges long-held biases and has undoubtedly inspired children of all backgrounds to pursue their innate curiosity and creativity. Her books also equip families to support and encourage their children to learn and grow through challenges, including through failure. I'm personally grateful to Miss Beatty's books for coming into my daughter's life at the exact moment when she was beginning to show us how creative and curious she is. The Rosie Revere character spoke to her as only a kindred spirit can. And I am so grateful that I got to witness the joy this brought her. In my work at the Chicago Community Trust, I'm encouraged to see leaders in every sector of our economy prioritizing diversity and inclusion with new energy and vigor. I'm so pleased that the DuPage Children's Museum has selected Andrea Beatty as the 2021 Great Friend to Kids Awards recipient. She is exactly what our children need her to be, demonstrating multicultural representation, celebrating diversity, and giving children permission to make mistakes. Her bold way of calling out life's limitations and the limitations we place on ourselves gives kids the courage to learn through failure. And we all know that vulnerability, this type of exploration, take both courage and encouragement. I'm honored to join you today in celebration of Andrea's commitment to ensuring all children can find themselves in books that help them feel that they belong, even when they're making mistakes, which is so vital in our world right now. Please join me in congratulating the DuPage Children's Museum Great Friend to Kids Award honoree, Andrea Beatty.
Thank you. I am so excited. I'm thrilled. This is amazing. First of all, I love the DuPage Children's Museum. I love this place. I love what you guys do for kids in this county and from far and afield even. I know people come here. But I want to let you know, too, that I have kind of a long personal connection here with museum. When I was a new mom and had tiny kids, and that was like a long time ago, I used to come to the museum when it was in Wheaton. And, you know, we were new to the area. I had no family here. I had no friends here. I was just getting set up. And it was a place to go and a place to connect with other moms. And just, it was kind of like a second home, especially on those long, long, long winter days. Because, man, winters are long here. But I never in a million years would have anticipated being here today and receiving this amazing, beautiful award. Thank you so much.
Andrea, you are a complete inspiration to us, and your characters have been a complete inspiration to us throughout this pandemic. They are role models for resilience, courage, bravery, and just having fun and discovering their world. And you created that world, and we could not be more excited than to give you this Great Friends to Kids Award.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for accepting it.
Thank you.
Congratulations to author Andrea Beatty, and thank you for creating a space that honors the unique abilities of children who can see themselves in your stories. From your creativity and vision to celebrate curiosity and its many possibilities, DCM took notice. You sparked an idea that led to a compelling proposal embraced by thought leaders across a variety of industries. Considerable planning and collaboration always go into developing a museum exhibit, and tonight we are so delighted to share with you a sneak peek at the fabrication of Ada Twist House, coming to DCM in October. Was incredible. A little behind the scenes, and I wanted to show you a little behind the scenes of my green screen here at our ABC7 studios. You know, we cannot wait to bring the ABC camera crew out to the Children's Museum in October to share that entire exhibit experience with our audience. At the top of the program, Mark Trumbacki shared his pride about the museum's exhibits that allow children to explore the endless possibilities that are at the museum. CEO Andrea Wiles took us deeper into the strategy and purpose of DCM's work to support parents and caregivers through a variety of pathways and partnerships. So to help you understand the impact of DCM's mission, I am so delighted to introduce you to a story about partners in play. Funded by a grant from the Institute for Museum and Library Services, DuPage Children's Museum's Young Explorers Project was created to ensure children aged 0 to 3 have access to high quality, informal educational resources. This program helps build and support the child-adult learning partnership that is just so crucial for success in school and in life. It begins laying the foundation for learning at a young age while helping parents and caregivers feel confident in facilitating and supporting their child's development through playful interactions. To learn more about the significance and lasting impact of this work, we will hear from partners and participants in the project's educational program, Partners in Play.
My name is Vivi Luna. I work for District 131 in East Aurora, and I oversee 6 parent educators who are part of our prenatal to age 3 home visiting program. Partners in Play is a wonderful program that reached out to us to see if we wanted to collaborate and work with our parents to introduce them to the DuPage Children's Museum and just kind of support them in the parenting journey of raising 0 to 3. So the Partners in Play program is the best thing ever, and it aligns so nicely to what our mission is, to empower students to reach their full potential. When I heard about PIP and the team called out and said if we were interested, we were definitely a yes. PIP does coaching for parents and how to play with their children. And we invite them and provide some certain toys for them to use with their babies. And then we also align how that play is helping their child's development. And that's an eye-opener for parents. We're able to encourage and promote that cognitive development, those language skills, those social skills, that these are all foundational for children's learning and lifelong success, really.
Partners in Play is a program that's meant for parents with young children under a year old who want to find new ways to discover like play with their children. And so through that, there's different ways with different materials, different everyday like things from home. So the first time I heard about Partners in Play was through Team Parent Connection, which was now pre-COVID. And so now I've had 2 kids go through the program. I had Skylar go through it and now Milo. And so the second time around, I had the opportunity, like I asked if I could do it again with Milo, and they said, of course. And so here I am. Just seeing how important play really is, how it is more than just, you know, kids being kids, just playing around, how they really can learn from everyday play. It really made me kind of like sit back and kind of really watch what they're doing now, really being more engaged, being more like hands-on with them, one-on-one, and just really communicating in different ways with them. With Skylar, it's just been able to really just be one-on-one with her and just seeing how smart she really is. Like, she may be only 2, but she is so verbal, and she loves just being hands-on on everything. Like, she loves to color, and she's already starting to kind of practice spelling, which is crazy, but it's just little things like that. Just really enjoyed this program a lot, and I've been so blessed that I've been able to do this twice around, and so definitely recommend it to any parents that are available or able to do this program, because they do get a lot out of it and they do learn so much, and the kids definitely love it too. The Children's Museum really is for everybody. You will have so much fun regardless of whether you're 2 or 102. You know, this is the place where it's really just bringing families together and just being able to spend time with their kids, their grandkids, nephews, nieces, whoever it is. And it's just really being family oriented, and I think that's so important.
There you have it, the many reasons why DCM is a cultural necessity worthy of our support. Not only is the museum a place to bring families together to have fun, but it's an organization that identifies and dismantles barriers in order to provide programs, partnerships, resources, and support to ensure a bright and joyful future for all children. So to wrap up the evening's program with some final words of inspiration and appreciation, DCM CEO Andrea Wiles.
What an incredible evening and program. I want to thank our board of directors, especially Mark Trumbacki, for his years of dedicated service and leadership and commitment to all things DCM. Thank you to Larry Larson and Cam Kniss for co-chairing the Play Soirée Committee, and all of our event sponsors, especially presenting sponsor Molex, lead sponsor Wintrust, and advocate sponsors PNC and the Robert R. McCormick Foundation. Tonight has been a celebration of creativity, resilience, and perseverance, as illuminated by the community partners, our incredible DCM team, and the philanthropic support provided by each of you, our donors. Our future is bright. We are so excited about the weeks and months ahead. Seeing children and families back inside the building, meeting them in their communities, and preparing for the opening of our questionnaires exhibit, when we will welcome Rosie, Iggy, Ada, and Sophia. Special thanks to our keynote speaker and motivator extraordinaire, Dr. Jatia Hart, to Andrea Sines from the Chicago Community Trust for introducing our great Friend to Kid Awards recipient, Andrea Beatty, who inspires all of us to envision a world where all children have equitable access to exceptional STEAM learning experiences. Thank you.